स्टूडेंट्स साइरा दिस इज मेघा मिस हियर एंड टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद आवर लेसन नंबर 3 दैट इज करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. ओके स्टूडेंट दिस इज आवर सेशन 5. नाउ टिल नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड मेनी ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन दिस चैप्टर. लास्ट प्रेजेंटेशन वी स्टडीड अबाउट द रेजिस्टर्स विच आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज. येस स्टूडेंट्स वी स्टडीड अबाउट द resistors, okay, which are connected in the series. That means they are connected one behind the other, okay. They are connected in a straight line, one behind the other, okay. And of course, all other components were also there of the circuit. You have an ammeter to measure the current. You had the voltmeter to measure the voltage, okay. Then what you had, students, you had a key, you had a cell, okay. Connecting wires and other different we have seen the current which is flowing through that circuit, okay. We have seen, okay, and what happens we have seen, okay. Now we have also seen one of the equation, right? What was that equation, students? We will just see. When the resistors are in series, you have RS, that is the effective resistance, okay. Total effective resistance is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, okay. You have seen this. And if n resistors are connected in series, means what? N means number of, okay. If number of resistors they are connected in series, you get it as RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus so on plus Rn. Okay, students. So, you have studied about this, okay, in the last presentation. And we have seen the circuit diagram also. Okay, students. Now, today we are going to study the resistors when they are connected in parallel. Okay. So, see here. The next one is the resistors in parallel. Now, the resistors are said to be connected in parallel when their ends are connected at both the sides. Okay. As shown in figure 3.9. We are going to see that figure. The figure shows three resistors. Yes, in series also you had three resistors. Here also in parallel you are going to have the three resistors, that are R1, R2 and R3. Okay, connected in parallel between the points C and D. Okay, V is the potential difference between C and D. Now, of course, potential difference will be there, which we are going to take it in volts, which you write it as V, okay. Let I1, I2 and I3 be the current flowing through R1, R2 and R3 respectively. Yes, students, in the last presentation, when you were studying about the series, you saw that the current which is flowing through the circuit remained the same, okay. Through all the resistors, same amount of current was passing, okay, students. Now, here you will be seeing that your current has changed to I1, I2 and I3, but the potential difference, that is the V, is remaining constant along all the three resistors, okay. What is the difference in series and parallel, students? The arrangement of the resistors, and there in the series the current remains constant, in parallel the voltage remains constant, okay, students. So we'll proceed. See here, this is the circuit diagram for the resistors in parallel. Can you see here, students? You have three resistors. This is your 1, 2 and 3. These are your three resistors. It is written R1, R2 and R3. Okay. And how they are arranged? They are arranged one below the other, not side by side. Okay. In series, they were besides each other, one by one. Okay. Side by side. And here they are arranged one below the other. Okay. And you will see that you have the two points C and D. Okay. And voltage is measured along this point C and D, which remains constant. Voltage I am talking, which we are going to measure in this voltmeter, okay. Ammeter current is going to change. Can you see? So how many ammeters you are having? 3 ammeters, okay, students. These 3 ammeters are showing the current. For R1 it will be I1, for R2 it will be I2, and for R3 it will be I3, okay, students. And what is remaining? Yes, main important thing is your cell. We write it as E. Okay, capital E, you write it for cell. Okay, or you can write the spelling also, C-E-L-L. And this is your key. We write it as K. Okay, students, connecting wire surely you will need. So I hope till this part, how the circuit looks, you have understood. Okay, students, now should we proceed? Now we will see what equation we are getting here. Okay, now see here. Now I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Okay, total current will be equal to the I1 plus I2 plus I3. Let RP, P for parallel, be the effective resistance between C and D. Okay, according to Ohm's law. Now what is the Ohm's law, students? You know the equation. V is equal to I R, right? But now what you require, students? You know this current. Okay, so it will become here, it will go to upon, so V upon R. Okay, so I is equal to, it will become V upon R. Okay, now here R is our effective resistance in parallel, so I have written it as RP. Okay, now similarly I1 will become V upon R1, I2 will become V upon R2, and I3 will become V upon R3. Okay, students, I is equal to V upon RP. Similarly, I1 is equal to V upon R1, I2 is equal to V upon R2, and I3 is equal to V upon R3. Is it clear, students? Why we have kept voltage, as the voltage is going to, potential difference is going to remain constant. So we have not made it as V1, V2 and V3. Okay, we have kept it constant throughout. Is it clear till here, students? Yes. So now, substituting this in equation 1. This is our equation 1, students. In that, you now got value of I also you have. I1 you have, I2 you have, and I3 you have. All this value for this equations you have. Okay. So we will substitute and we will see what is going to happen. Okay. So see here. Substituting this in equation 1, you get V upon RP. Okay, is equal to V upon R1 plus V upon R2 plus V upon R3. Okay, now you can see voltage, as I told you, is same. So can I take V common everywhere? Yes. So it will become 1 upon RP is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Okay, so if I want to get the the total effective resistance in parallel, if I want to calculate, I have to reciprocal the individual resistances of resistors and get the answer. I have to sum it up. Okay, so if n resistors are connected in parallel, 1 upon RP is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 plus so on and on it will go till plus 1 upon Rn. N is the number of resistors which are connected. Okay, students, in series you have Rs is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, so on and Rn, right? Here is just the reciprocals. 1 upon Rp, as it is parallel, is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 plus so on plus 1 upon Rn. Okay, students, I hope till here it is clear to you. Okay, so now, even if any one of these several bulbs, okay, many bulbs are connected in parallel, for example, becomes unfunctional. Now, when number of bulbs are connected in parallel, and if any one of the bulb is not working because of some damage to its filament, okay, for example, they are saying, then what will happen, students? The circuit does not break as the current flows through the other paths. Yes, what it is saying, if many bulbs are connected in parallel and one of the bulb is not working, then also the circuit will not break, okay, and the current will flow through the other path to the circuit, okay, and the rest of the bulbs light up. Okay, students, when several bulbs are connected in parallel, they emit the same amount of light as when they are connected individually in the circuit. okay, when they are connected in parallel, if many bulbs are connected in parallel, they emit the same amount of light, even though individually if I light up the bulbs, okay. While the bulbs connected in series emit less light than when connected individually. If in series I connect many of the bulbs, you see that the light which we get is less. Okay, the what you can say, the light, the flash of light what you get is the less as compared when you individually light them up. Okay, but if you connect all the bulbs in the parallel, same amount of light they will give when they are individually lighten up. Okay, students, so most of the time in our houses and all, we have parallel connections also sometime. Why? Because one of the thing is not working, current should not stop. Okay, it should move, other things should be work. Nah? So sometimes in the houses, they make up the parallel connections so that even though one thing is not working, at least because of the parallel connection, the other thing can work. Okay, students, which is not possible in the series. Is it clear, students? I am talking about the light bulbs and all what are attached. Okay, students. So I hope till here it is understood to you. Should we proceed the next? Okay. So if a number of resistors are connected in parallel, this is the important five characteristics which you have to remember. We have studied the same five characteristics in series also. Okay, that also you are going to remember. Please make a note of it. Learn by heart it. Okay. The inverse, what is the first point, student? The inverse of the effective resistance is equal to the sum of the inverse of individual resistances. Yes, inverse we are talking about because 1 upon Rp it is. Okay, so the inverse of the effective resistance is equal to the sum of, that is 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. Okay, sum of the inverse of the individual resistances. Okay, the current flowing through an individual resistor is proportional to the inverse of its resistance, and the total current flowing through the circuit is the sum of the currents flowing through the individual resistors. Yes, we have seen I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Yes, so that only it is written in the words. Again, I'll repeat, the current flowing through an individual resistor, okay, is proportional to the inverse of its resistance, and the total current flowing through the circuit is the sum of the currents flowing through individual resistors. Okay, students, then the potential difference across the ends of all resistors is the same. Yes, V value, that is the voltage, that is the potential difference, remains constant along all the resistors which are connected in parallel. Okay, the effective resistance of the resistors connected in parallel is less than the least resistance of the individual resistors. Okay, again I'll repeat, the effective resistance, that is 1 upon Rp connected, that is of the resistors connected in parallel, means 1 upon Rp value is less than, okay, the least resistance of the individual resistors, means the least whatever the resistance will be there of the individual, means 1 upon R1 values, whatever it will be there, it, the 1 upon Rp value will be the less one. Okay, this arrangement is used to reduce the resistance in the circuit. Okay, means what? It, this type of arrangement, if you are having in the circuit, then the flow of the current will be without any hindrance. Okay, that means resistance is reduced, the hindrance is reduced in the flow of the current. Okay, for what we are using series, students? To increase the resistance, and for parallel it is reducing the resistance in the circuit. Okay, students, so here we complete with the part of the resistors which are connected in the series and which are connected in the parallel. This is more important for you as this you are going to study again and again in your higher standards also. So please go through the circuit diagram also you draw in the notebooks and practice, and write down this five characteristics, okay, for both series and parallel. Okay, students, so we'll proceed. Next part you have in your text is the domestic use of the wires it is given. Okay, domestic means what? The household, how in the your house, how the electrical connections are there. Okay, now that table for time being it has been skipped from your syllabus for this year, but students, it's a request, just read it and keep, because next year you're going to again have it, so that time you will be learning again, but for just an information you can read. Okay, next part after that is the fuse wire. All these boxes are given in your text. Okay, and the next part is given about the precautions what we have to use during use of this electricity. So that part also journal uses whatever precautions and how to use the electricity, it is given that not to waste the electricity, and also that also part you can read. Okay, between that is the fuse wire, which you have it in your syllabus this year, so we are going to study that. Okay, and this is the last part for your lesson. What is the fuse wire, students? Fuse wire is used to protect domestic appliances. Domestic means whatever the appliances which you use at home. Okay, to protect that all things we have a fuse wire. Okay, domestic appliances, I hope mixer grinders and whatever you are using, for that you have the fuse wires in that. Okay, it is made up of a mixture of a substance and has a specific melting point. Okay, students, so it is made up of mixture of substance, not a single substance, but many substances are mixed together. Okay, and has a specific melting point, a specific value of a melting point. It is connected in series to the electric appliances. So see here, now here the series connections is used. Okay, so the fuse wire, it is connected in series with the electric appliance. If for some reason the current in the circuit increases excessively, okay, sometimes it happens, the flow of the current is very of a higher speed, okay, the fuse wire gets heated up and melts. So what will happen to this fuse wire? This fuse wire, as it has got a particular melting point, right? So what it will happen, whatever the excess of the heat will be there because of the passage of high amount of the current, it will be absorbed by this fuse wire and it will start melting. Okay, the circuit gets broken and the flow of current stops. And as it starts melting, what will happen, students? The circuit gets broke down there. Okay, and what will happen? Current will stop, because circuit is only broken, so how the current will flow? So current also stops, thus protecting the appliance, and hence the appliance gets protected. Okay, because of this fuse wire. This wire is fitted in a groove in a body of a porcelain like non-conducting material. Okay, porcelain means, I hope you have seen the china dish, white color, that small dish in the lab. Okay, which we say it as china dish also. Okay, it is made up of porcelain, white color. Okay, so what it is, this wire, where it is fitted, student? It is fitted in a groove, means in that porcelain, like a stone only it is, in that a groove is made, and inside that the wire is fitted, like an as the porcelain is a non-conducting material. Okay, for domestic use, fuse wires with upper limits of 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A, 5A and 10A are used. Okay, students, so for domestic users, we use the upper limits, means this is the limits given for the use of this fuse wires capacity. Okay, students, so you can see the pictures of the fuse wires also, see how they look like. You have the ceramic fuse. Okay, you can see the picture of this ceramic fuse also and cartridge fuse also. Okay, students, so fuse wires are now very important for us to protect our appliances from getting damaged, as if there is a high amount of current flowing through the circuit, it can be stopped with the help of this fuse wire. Okay, students, 10th standard again you are going to study about the fuse wire. Okay, so please study this part also properly. This whole chapter is connected with, again, with your 10th standard, one of the chapters. So please study this chapter properly. Whatever notes you are making, make it properly so that you will be able to use it in the next year also. Okay, students. So I hope today's part, what we have done, you have understood. Here we have completed with the lesson also. Okay, we have completed with our lesson number 3, that is current electricity. This was the last part, students. But we will be meeting in the next presentations. And we will be with the same chapter, we are going to do the sums. Okay, students, so please go through this chapter you don't have now for the exams, but study them, make the notes and keep. Okay students, whatever the important part I told you, circuit diagrams and all, try to practice them. Next year you again have them. Okay, so I hope today's part, the resistors in parallel, what we studied, we did the revision for the resistors in series and fuse wires we saw. I hope these parts are clear to you. Okay, so thank you children. We'll meet in the next presentation. Take care. Sairam.